Cheers, everyone. Happy Friday. We've made it officially to the weekend almost. If you're on the West Coast, we're almost to that time of day where we get to go home and do a bunch of laundry and catch up on things that we've been putting off all week. If you're over on the East Coast or elsewhere, you have passed that 5 o'clock mark. Congratulations. It's your weekend. With that being said, I'm going to raise a glass because we have an awesome artist today. Goes by the name of Chaz Cardigan in a cardigan.
Hi.
How are we doing?
I'm so good. Yeah, I'm one of the two cardigans I own. I'm trying to break it in.
I love it. What's the color of the other?
Gray. It's really boring.
Great. Well, you know, gray is versatile, and it could be boring, but I feel like you work it to where it's not.
Not boring. You know what? Wrong word. Classic. It's classic.
Yes. It's just, it's neutral. It's Switzerland.
This is my Swiss cardigan. I like it.
Yes. And we were just talking about Scandinavia and all its battleship glory. So very, very fitting. All right. So what do you say, Chaz? We just get right into the first song and then we'll chat after.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. Cheers.
I'm going to take my headphones off every time I play a song just so I don't have to have them clunking about. This is a song about how bad days don't last forever, which is great because I've had a weird couple days, but it's all good. Here we go. It's called Everything's Wrong. What's up, Billy? Hi, Amelia. Pablo Riley. What a lovely, lovely breakdown. I've been riding this for days now. Been trying to surf the wake out. Come through, get the fuck up out my way now. Guess it isn't all rose and roses. Every day can't be avocado toast. Overpriced at a West End hotel. Hoping my smoke signals reach the coast. Oh well, heard I better learn my place. Heard I better learn to race before it turns to a murder case. It's a crazy world. They give you love online, then hold a gun to your face. It's about time I felt something new running around my mind like an animal, looking for one good goddamn excuse. I wish I could just let it go. Everything's wrong. Baggage can't erase this, but I know you do too, at least I know my station. Why you so fixed on being somebody that you wouldn't like if you met him at a party? Why is it so hard to keep your own opinion and not break under pressure like a politician? It's about time I felt something new running around my mind like an animal, looking for one good goddamn excuse. I wish I could just let it go. Everything's wrong. Everything's all wrong. And I've never been better. Guess I'm just not what I wanted all along. But it only gets better. Ooh, I'm talking about everything. 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 Yeah, everything. Everything. For instance, I'm having a carpal tunnel flare-up right now. My gear got damaged on a flight yesterday, but it's okay, because we're here together, we got music. I wish I could just let it go. Everything's wrong, everything's all wrong, and I've never been better. Guess I'm just not what I wanted all along, but it only gets better.
Nashville. Cheers. Thank you. Chaz Cardigan, everybody.
Hi.
Thank you if you're joining us right now. And it looks like we've got some folks in the comments. Let's take a look. Let's see. Joshua W. Looper or Looper says, damn, that carpal. Yeah. Doesn't look like he's having a lot of fun with it, but we are having fun right now.
Yeah, it's going
to
be good.
Amelia on YouTube says that they love this song so freaking much. And Billy gives you a round of applause.
Hi, friends. A lot of my Patreon, my like Discord crew here, love you all. Thank you.
I'm so looking forward to the rest of the show. And it's crazy because you said you haven't done a show technically in like a few weeks.
Do you know what's so weird? I do these live streams all the time on my TikTok, on my Instagram. I go live and play songs for like an hour. But for whatever reason, whenever I do things like this where there's a sponsor, it's more live streamy and, you know, there's a link to it. There's a whole production element. I always get so fucking nervous, Sam. And I can't tell you why, because I do it every day. But no, I haven't sang in a few days. It's been a few days of just like I've been in Los Angeles for 3 weeks just working and finishing up a bunch of content, and I just did not have time to go live over the last few days. So it made me nervous today, like, oh gosh, am I gonna have a voice? Am I gonna be okay? I'm fine. I'm gonna be fine.
I love it. Yeah, no, we're going to have a blast, and this will make you feel less nervous. So I've been doing this many times a week for over a year now, and I used to get just super nervous, and you know, it's hard to think that I'm just talking to you or I'm talking to whoever, but we can't see like all the people at home snacking on something or, you know, just hanging out with their family watching this. And that used to freak me out, but I think it's so cool now. Everyone's human, and I think we've seen so much of that through like all this raw footage that we've gotten to be exposed to through artists' Instagram lives and everything this past year. And we've seen so many mistakes or, you know, I don't want to say the F word. I'm only given one F word per show, so I'll save it. But one fudge up.
We're given one F word per show, okay.
No, I am. You have as many as you want. Cool. But I think that it's almost the beauty in this new version of display of artistry is seeing that human side to things. Also, I know you're a Virgo moon. So when I was looking at your name like a week ago, two C's, my name's Sam Smith, two S's, and I just love the flow of that. So it made me less nervous before I even met you.
No, I love it. I love the synchronicity.
So that first song that you just did, that's the intro song off of what you released last October.
Yes. Correct? Yeah, that's off my record Hologramma.
Okay, so when it comes to Hologramma, like you had said that basically what you put out through that release was what you would have wanted to hear as a teenager.
Yeah.
And the first thing that you ever put out into the world in 2016, you were going by a different moniker.
I was. No one ever talks about this. Yeah, my name was Chaz Cardigan at the time.
So how did that name come about? Was that through childhood and experiences through douche pickles?
Yeah. I was a really twitchy kid. I was awkward, and still I can't control a lot of my like facial tics sometimes, mm-hmm. and blink at weird times. And I got called Spaz all the time because it's an easy jump from Chaz to Spaz. And I was putting music out under my birth name for years as a teenager that I've tried to wipe from the internet. Some of it's still floating around. But I took a break for a second, and I wrote that first Chaz Cardigan record, and I wanted to put it out under a different name just to see what would happen. I mean, I wrote it more honestly, I think, because of it. I think at the time, finding a different name actually gave me the freedom to just be as real and personal as possible. It wasn't playing a caricature or anything.
Yeah.
And I got to the name because my last name is Scottish, and Chaz Cardigan was the perfect, it's the same amount of syllables, it's another Scottish last name, and it was a perfect anagram for, no, sorry, not anagram, it's a perfect analog to my name, and it felt like a real name. What happened was I signed a record deal under that name, and then the UK and the international teams all said, hey, that word is actually illegal to say over here on the radio, and you can't say it in Canada, Australia, the UK, parts of South America.
Spaz?
Well, it's a really antiquated and mean word for people on the autism spectrum. And so once I found that out, it was like a no-brainer. It was like, but you know what? I remember a few years prior, I talked to this guy about potentially managing me from the UK, and he didn't say much about it. He did say, you might want to know spaz means something different over here. That's all he said. And I wish he had told me, because what happened when I was on that particular record label was that the international team said, we just flat out can't put that word on TV. You're not going to get shows over here. Mm-hmm. You're not going to get any publicity because this word is hurtful. And frankly, mm-hmm. you're not that guy. And it'd be different if you were a punk band called, like, Fuck the Government or something. But right. you're not. So, and it was an easy jump, you know. People were already Googling, oh, what's his real name? And interviews had already mentioned it. So it was easy. That's where the name came from.
I love it. Yeah, language is such an interesting thing to me. And I think that the best part about language and music, especially, is the way that music can transcend no matter what country you reside in or what language you know. There's something about music that brings people together. And even if you don't necessarily know what is being, you know, in the message of the lyrics, if you don't know the language, even if that isn't exactly being translated to you fully, it's something where people can relate to certain music when someone's bearing their soul, like you did through Hologramma and really just transcended a lot of things that people are afraid to breach a lot of the times when it comes to talking about your experiences and putting it out there for people to relate to, hopefully. That's something that I think people tend to be fearful of, as they should. But you just went out there and you did it, and I'm just so proud of you. I've never even hugged you or met you, but I think you're doing a great job.
Thanks, Sam. I really appreciate that.
And for everyone who's watching right now, so for any updates as we progress through 2021, any tours or shows that might come about, any updates whatsoever, there's a newsletter at chazcardigan.com, and that banner is going to magically pop up in a second here, maybe. I don't know. See? Let's manifest it. Yeah? No?
We're not going to worry about it.
But make sure that you subscribe to that newsletter. And also, you can find the Instagram account and the Facebook, both the same thing. So it's just at Chaz Cardigan. And if you're feeling tipsy today, I've got some jokes in store. A sip per joke if you have some wine handy. Then, by the end of today's show, if you're feeling tipsy, venture over to the virtual tip jar. Venmo is the same thing, at Chaz Cardigan. And let's get him a third cardigan. That's what I think.
Well, I'll say, too, a lot of people in this chat are subscribed to me on Patreon. I don't expect any of you to go over on Venmo because you quite literally pay my rent already, so I love all of you so much.
Aww. That's really sweet. Well, shout out to everyone.
But anyone else who doesn't pay me on Patreon,
yeah,
you get over to Venmo, please.
Oh, my goodness. Well, my coworker brought me a large heaping serving of wine. So if you're at home and you've got a beverage, let's raise a glass to Chaz. We've got more music in store for all of you, and we're going to be dropping links over the course of today's show as to where you can find the Jam Cellar's Easy to Love wines that are right here behind me. We're going to make sure Chaz gets his wine, and shout out to Chaz's manager. Hope you're enjoying yours.
Shout out to my money guy, Steve, who got my wine instead of
yeah,
me.
Yeah, Steve.
Would you like to hear another?
You want to do two back to back?
Yeah, let's do it.
Sweet.
So this is one that I wanted to put out, and my label didn't like it, and then I leaked it on TikTok, and then people did like it, and then I got dropped, and then it came out. So this one's really special for me. Mm-hmm. dancing, jumping off buildings and breaking my habits just to be different. I got a new haircut and switched all my numbers. Sometimes I'm scared I'll be calling my mother, so I'll keep moving. I'll be somebody new. When I see you again, I'll be somebody new. Sound I like, but nothing really lasts forever. Got a new haircut, new highlights, new colors. Sometimes I think I'm becoming my mother, but just one more haircut don't fix all my numbers. I think I should shut up and I'll blow my cover, so I'll keep moving. I'll be somebody new. When I see somebody new. One more start over, one more I'm a mess, one more here we go again. One more long night that I know I regret. I heard someone say life is a long time not to change. When I see you again, I'll be somebody new. Between your point of view and mine, it's just the difference of being at different points in space and time. I only have this body, victim of my history. Sorry if I put you on the edge like an amphetamine. It's all I know. I'm trying to learn to let it go. Oh no, lose data or I lose control. We're all making it up as we go. At least I'm told. Falling down, it's less and less confusing as you see the tide come back around. It's no use dwelling on it, no use being haunted. Everything is something you can call it what you wanna call it. It's hard sometimes, we wanna skip and press rewind. Oh my, we're walking on a tightrope, but it's like the future's never looked so bright. But I feel fine. Say hello to be human. We're all just dancing on the timeline, and no one knows where the hell we're going. We're all fucked up and we're alright. And we're alright. We're all fucked up and we're alright. I miss playing live shows because I can make this a sing-along moment. We can drag it out a little bit with the band, you know, right here, and I have you sing. And then I would do. I got time, but I can't afford it. I'm broken and better for it. I got love, but it's metaphoric. I'm broken and better for it. So say hello, to be a human. We're all just dancing on the timeline. And no one knows where the hell we're going. We're all fucked up and we're alright. So say hello, to be a human. We're all just dancing on the timeline. And no one knows where the hell we're going. We're all fucked up.
Thank you, and the crowd goes crazy. Woo! Thank you.
I love that one.
So, Chaz, that, first of all, just, I need to give you another round of applause. But, secondly, please explain to me. So, you have all these people, I don't know if they're from Discord or from where, but someone, let me find it. Someone said something about melons.
We're going to ask about the watermelons?
Yeah. Well, yeah. I need to know. And you have so much love out there. And I just want you to know, like, it is so warranted. You deserve it so much.
Thank you.
But please tell me.
Yeah, so I have to tell you, Sam, yes. I don't have control over that one. It started, as I understand it, I was playing the only show I got to play last year, like real true show, was a live stream show with the full band. And someone, I think it was a typo, commented a watermelon, and then people started running with it, and it became a thing. And then by the end of the show, it didn't exist before I logged on. And then at the end of the show, it became a thing that everybody was posting, and it got attached to Haircut because... when I started teasing that song, it was just this, like, totem for the Cardi gang here. And then they started, like, attaching it to everything in the Discord, and it became the Chazzermelon. And then when I decided I was going to put out Haircut, I'm like, well, that's the cover art, right? So I literally took the Discord watermelon emoji, and that's the cover of Haircut.
I love that. I love that so much.
It's a whole thing. And so I have, and so now I know there are people who were talking about getting a watermelon tattoo, and I have a gummy bear tattoo, so that's like another little, you know, totem for us. But the watermelon is so, like, the slice of watermelon, it's powerful.
Now, please tell me, and don't give me the wrong answer, what is your favorite flavor of gummy bear? Just don't say orange.
Do you know my hot take is that all gummy bears actually taste the same, and it's a placebo effect that we tell ourselves they taste different.
No.
No, I know. Actually, my favorite are the clear ones.
Yes, the pineapple.
Love the pineapple.
Yes.
Amelia's getting a watermelon tattoo. Holy shit.
When is your tattoo scheduled, Amelia? Let us know. That's crazy. That's amazing.
Amelia, I'm proud of you for waiting until you got out of school to do that. That was proud of you.
And Amelia, please tell us, what is your, please say the clear gummy bear, but what is your favorite flavor of gummy bear? Everyone in the comments, let us know. Because if it's orange, it's not really orange. It's like that bright golden color.
Yeah, and I like the red and the clear.
The red, the green, and the clear. Sometimes I'll mix it up and, like, eat all three flavors at once. But sometimes I, like, hold back. I try to. But my Taurus moon, you know, snacking is just in my nature, so. All right. Who else has commented? Okay, we've got Josh Windy or Windy. It's all Y's. W-Y-N-D-Y.
I'm going to say Windy.
Yeah. Josh, red, and... oh, lemon. That's the one. And I'm normally a lemon person.
I like Billy's take here. Hold on. Are American gummy bears flavored? And then Ryan says, Billy, are UK gummy bears not?
Well, see, that would just be silly. Oh,
see, so I think actually, Billy, I'm thinking of jelly babies, which do not really have a flavor.
No. It tastes like if candle wax was like fruit flavored.
Oh, no.
That's
no,
what I think.
No besmirching jelly babies here.
I love candles.
I love.
I burn like 8 candles at a time when I'm home.
Oh my God. I mean, I've got one on right now. I'd pick it up, but it's too hot.
Of course. You're a Virgo moon. Like, I would really be upset if you didn't have one burning. Pablo says the red, obviously. Okay. He has a strong opinion about the red gummy bears. Love it. Greetings from Germany, says Magdalene. I don't know how to do a German accent.
Oh, Brick. So. Ryan, to answer that question, the first wild world I ever made was the history of gummy bears, and I talk about jelly babies in there.
Okay, I was gonna ask you about this because basically this is like a web series, like weekly. I don't know if you're still doing it, but it's like 60 seconds. You do like philosophy ideas, history, science, and you just into 60 seconds.
Try to condense, yeah.
Dude, I love that.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
I love it. Wild World has become so cumbersome to maintain making. I tried to pick it up again this year and I got 2 episodes out and it was just so much work. And the first run that I did while I was with the major label, and it was more like they didn't really do much to help, I gotta say, but they did facilitate getting a space and a small crew to help make the thing. I wrote and researched all of the episodes in 2 days, and it was just this flurry. I wrote 20 episodes, filmed them all in a day, and then we put them out over the next year every week. And then I always wanted to do it again. I had all these ideas, and I kept thinking, I'll film them in bulk, I'll do this, I'll do that. Mm-hmm. And then it became this thing that when I tried to pick it up a couple months ago, I mean, it was 2 weeks of my life to research and write and shoot and edit the thing on top of finishing an album and planning music videos and negotiating a new record deal. And it just became this very cumbersome thing that was like, I love Wild World, but I think I need to maintain it in space somehow. Mm-hmm. I think doing the big chunk bulk shoots, that's how I got to do it going forward.
Yeah, absolutely. And, okay. So kind of a side note, but so when it comes to like, when you first started within the music industry, I know like your punk rock band that you were within when you were 11,
yes.
I want to say, like you started very young and you're so talented and you just took it upon yourself to go after what you wanted to go after. And I know, as we all have, you hit some speed bumps, like you were, you wanted to go to college for, was it for just a music degree, but you didn't end up...
I got into film school.
Film school. Oh, that's so cool.
Yeah. And I couldn't afford it.
Yeah. Which is a whole nother topic, which I would love to do a podcast with you. I think it would be so much fun.
We have so much to talk about.
So much. Yeah, the higher education system is ridiculously overpriced and
it's bad.
And it's putting bad. Us all in a very strange position. But you managed to do your own thing despite that speed bump. And I'm just curious, like, what you have learned. I know that's a very vague question, so I'm going to size it down a little bit.
Oh,
like,
gosh, yeah.
You know, looking back a decade ago or, you know, 5 years ago, what, especially in this past year, do you think that you have improved on within your creative process or within your understanding and learning of the music industry or at when it comes to your entire individual output?
I think the big thing for me for the last year, and I've been sort of chipping away at this in therapy for years, but it was to stop basing my self-worth on my output. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, like you said, I've been making music for most of my life, and I've always been chasing this career path. And what that did for me as like an 11-year-old, a 12-year-old, a 13-year-old with a sizable MySpace profile, I'm 14 and I'm paying taxes and I'm playing shows and I'm traveling across state lines, is that I took myself so seriously, Sam, from such a young age. And also, you know, how could you not? But I was an insufferable little shit because of it, because I just took my, I thought I was just so serious. I was just, I wanted to be an adult so badly, and I was surrounded by adults, you know, telling me, you've got this, you're gonna do this. And but you know, as soon as I stopped turning in songs that they were really excited about, they would go away. And or, you know, an adult would come into my life and be like, I'm gonna make you a star, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna, give me $30,000 somehow, and I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna change your life. And then that wouldn't happen, and they would go away, or I would slow down making songs because I was depressed and in high school, and then they would go away. So and also that, you know, we're in a good place now, but I think so much of my relationship with my family as like a queer person growing up in Kentucky was so strained that the only thing we really could meet in the middle on was about music and work. That very, like, American Protestant work ethic, you know?
Yep.
So I was taught from a really early age that who I was and my value is tied directly to songs. Well, what that did is that I wrote a song every day from the time I was 12 until I was 23, and then had a psychotic break, you know? Mm-hmm. And I just... I've really slowed down in writing. And it comes in seasons. I think that's the thing, is that there are moments where I'm writing two songs a day still. Mm-hmm. And moments, like right now, I'm working on a billion things and I haven't written a song for myself in a week or two. Mm-hmm. And you know what? It's okay.
That's like, literally so fine.
And I feel bad because I also had this, one of my benefits on my Patreon page is that I upload demos as soon as I'm finished with them, because I like sharing that process. But it's like, you know, when you're in the middle of doing other things, and also I'm about to move, so now I'm in like the boxing up process, and it's so hard to not base my worth on my output, even though I don't think no one else is doing that to you. So that's the biggest thing I've learned, is that your output is not your worth, and also don't take yourself so seriously. You are fortunately not the center of the universe.
Thank God.
Thank God. Thank whatever, whoever. I'm going to call it God, uppercase, lowercase, however you want to define that. It could be you. It could be everything. Thank God you're not the center of the universe.
And you know what? One of probably my favorite quotes that I have read is actually yours. Read it last night, and it's really resonated with me. And it's nothing less, and that's beautiful. Take it all in.
I don't remember where I said that, but that's a very Chaz thing to say for sure.
Someone was asking you what you want listeners to take away from your music, and that's the response that you gave. And it's stuck with me for the past 24 hours, and I just want you to know that.
Thank you for doing research, by the way. Yeah, I would call myself, and I know we've only got about, you know, 25 minutes here or so, but I would call my philosophy Zen nihilism for that. Nothing lasts, and it's beautiful. Mm-hmm. Take it all in.
Love that. So for everyone that's tuned in right now, thank you for being tuned in, by the way. We're going to get into another song in a sec. Real quick, Chaz, so Ryan on YouTube says, OMG, Chaz, you would have made my top 8 for MySpace. Aww. That's a MySpace reference.
God, I miss MySpace. That was a great social media.
Oh my God. What's the dude's name?
Tom,
yes, thank you. So we just heard, I believe it's the second song off of Vulnerabilia.
Yes.
Being Human, that's the last song that we just heard. Make sure that you check out all the social links, the website. We're going to be linking that all over the course of today's show. And before we get into another song, why can't humans hear over or under a certain frequency?
Why, Sam?
You sound so nervous. It hurts too much.
Oh my God, okay. I love you. I love cheers. You. That's great. Cheers.
cheers, everybody. Make sure that you check out our Easy to Love wines, which are right here behind me. Those are going to be linked at our website for you to purchase. Either you can get them directly shipped to your doorstep through our site. In addition to that, we have multiple options in terms of purchase. So check it out. Sorry, Josh Windy. He says, ouchie.
Oh, for the hurts.
Yes. Did it hurt? Okay. Anyways, what do we think about doing a fourth song?
Let's do it.
All right. Are you less nervous? Sorry. What? I was just saying, are you less nervous now?
Oh, so much.
Okay,
yeah.
Good.
It's so weird. Yeah. Stage fright's a whole other conversation. Love it. Yes. Thank you. Yeah. If you know, you know. I'm being real, so where's my money? If I don't steal, why am I running? I'm in that gold top shop, losing sleep and skipping costs. I got my finger on the button. Combine the me and my demeanor. Empty your smiles and a preacher. You got a Wi-Fi hotspot, Google me and screenshot. But I'm a hypersonic seizure. Corporations kill for it. Put up my face point blank next to don't believe the thing he says. Pay off the bouncer at the back door. Go chupacabra on my king shit. Fly in the opera just to leave it. Order the Cobain champagne and zipline on the mezzanine. I'm my own worst enemy. Wait, am I faking it cool? I'm hoping they find me. Take off and I nosedive. Not my fault, wishing I belong. Not my fault, I wait. Am I faking it all? I hope when they find me, I've got nothing on me. We were going down at the start. Soon as I hop on board, I'm a kamikaze.
Chaz Cardigan, everybody.
I love that one.
I love it as well. And that is the third song off of Hologramma?
Yeah, number three.
Okay. And so how do you like pick out the order when it comes to releasing things? Like how do you decide on the intro, the outro, everything in between?
Well, you know what I did? How did I do that for that one? I remember writing like an essay where I tried to like write out, because Hologramma was such an interesting one for me because it was the only album I've made with a major label, and the process of that was that I was writing all the time with a billion different people, and sort of in hindsight I had to look back and say, well, what was I saying this whole time? Because my life was just in this massive flux state. And so I remember like I took these favorites we knew we had and I tried to like extrapolate like, what am I saying here? because there's a real life shift happening here. I just don't know what it is. And then in writing out, well, this song is about this, this song is about this, this song is about this, the flow of it occurred to me, and then I thought, oh, well, yeah, that makes sense. So what was the actual trajectory of my life there? And right. Not in chronological order, but I tried to lay the songs out in a way that, like, took you on this journey of stasis, things not being good, looking back and thinking, well, what have I done in the past that made things not so good, and how did I end up here in the first place? And then saying, okay, well, it's time to close that chapter. It's time to put that time in a drawer to the left, I say, and let it rest. And the track list just formed naturally once I knew, well, this is what I've been circling around for the last 10 months of my life. This is the center of gravity I've been writing around. Then it just sort of flowed. And, you know, with a team that big, there's a fair amount of pushback of like, no, we need the single up front. No, we need this here. No, we need to roll it out. And it is, you know, it's... So there's definitely a give and take. There's a curation process. But that's how I got to the track list on Hologramma.
Heck yeah. When you were talking about hindsight, like, I keep thinking about this past year plus, the term, or the phrase, I should say, hindsight is 2020, now has just multiple meanings now. It's so insane.
You know do you know the only good thing that came out of COVID is I swore up and down before 2020 that whole year we were going to get a billion pop songs that all used, like, 2020 vision, or I'm seeing you in 2020, or, like, you know, crystal clear. I thought we were going to get a million songs like that. And you know what? The only good thing about COVID is that no one ever wants to reference that year ever again.
No.
No.
As far as I'm concerned, you know, there was 2019, and now we're here. And I don't know what happened in between. I'm not even going to really reference it as a legit point in time, because
we have to reconcile with it at some point, but you know what, for a little bit I think it's okay if we try to give ourselves some distance. I am happy though,
exactly.
Like, most of the music I've put out was during 2020, so that's been it was an intense, like, release period for me though.
Vulnerability, like, you literally, you released that I think the day before Valentine's Day of last year. So you put that out, like, almost exactly a month before shit hit the fan.
Yep.
And I think a lot of musicians that I've talked to, they've dealt with the same sort of scenario where either they released music that resonated with people so much right before the pandemic, but it was, like, relevant in terms of the lyrics during, or right at the beginning something was released and it was written pre-pandemic before everything was relevant, but still this is the beauty of, like, the universal language of music, is people were able to connect to these lyrics that were never even written with the intent of establishing that connection with the pandemic. It was all pre.
I did have this moment when we were figuring out the rollout plan for Hologramma where I just sat and thought, all of this just means something completely different now than it did 6 months ago.
Yeah.
Up to and including Everything's Wrong being the first single.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to take us to a lighter note because I know that you're a Star Wars dork.
Oh, I'm a dork. I'm a dork.
So, with Father's Day approaching, where does Princess Leia shop for Father's Day?
She can't. Alderaan's gone. Where does she shop?
At the Darth Maul.
Wow. 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 Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
I'm sorry. This is why your water should be wine, but Jesus was busy, so.
I love that. That was good. That was really good.
Now, what did the guitar say to the ukulele?
Oh, God. What?
Uke, I am your father.
Well, I don't have a response to that.
Yeah, that's okay.
This should be wine. That's on me.
Dang it, Jesus.
Dang it, Jesus.
Clear out your calendar.
I've been looking for him all my life.
All right. So thank you. Oh, Ryan says he's finishing his drink. Okay.
Go. I like that Josh says Chaz's dorkdom transcends Star Wars. It's very true.
I love the Mr. Rogers vibe you have going on, too, by
the
way.
Thank you.
It's a favorite show of mine as a kid. Okay. And I love the term, by the way, Cardi Gang. That is, you need to make that into merch somehow.
I would like to.
Ugh, so cool. But in the meantime, you do have merch. You have some really dope hoodies and tees, and the people can find that. So if you're watching and you want to get your hands on a hoodie or a tee, go to, I think it's www.store.chazcardigan.com.
Yes. Also, you can go to Chaz Cardigan and there's a store link that'll take you there.
Either one.
Oh, either one.
Or
sometimes,
both.
Sometimes we need a challenge.
Oh, okay. So let's get into, you want to do two songs back to back?
I'll do two songs back to back. Yeah.
Woo. Woo. Let's do it.
Let's do it. All right. This is called SOS. Just relearning what's elementary. I want to staple this into my memory this time. We're on the same side, I'm not your enemy. You gotta be better, that's what she said to me. We just can't keep on pretending that everything's alright. Oh, stop, wait a minute. I know I need to start listening. Stop, wait a minute. A struggle to tune in your frequency. I'm trying to learn to give up my need to be right. Oh, and stop. Wait a minute. I know I need to start listening. Stop. Wait a minute. Say goodbye. I wanna get over it. And I'm pull the same old shit. But I got. I'm gonna fuck it up again. I'm gonna take the line and deep dive. Yeah, I'm gonna fuck it up again. I'm gonna fuck it up again. I'm gonna fuck it up again. I'm gonna take the line and deep dive. I'm gonna fuck it up again. I wanna get over it. And up on the same old shit. But I got a way of getting in my way. I wanna. True. It's right, Billy. I could only play like three songs. Oh, Ryan, you know what? Congratulations. I got a million things to do. I got so much I want to prove. But life is like a Rubik's Cube, I'm stuck and I don't know which way to move. There's more to the story. We all need a taste of glory. So don't bore us, hit the chorus. Go big, get loud and go home. We gotta wake up every morning, see the day as a gift. You gotta check that bucket list before you go to the crib. Cause if you wanna light a fire, then you gotta get lit. You gotta live a little. Check that bucket list before you go to the crib. Cause if you wanna light a fire, then you gotta get lit. You gotta live a little bit, live a little bit, live a little. Life is waiting, why be patient? I don't know where the future goes. 8 billion people that feel alone, but ain't no time to feel broken love. Life is waiting, why be patient? Gotta wake up every morning, see the day is a gift. You gotta check that bucket list before you go to the crib. Cause if you wanna light a fire, then you gotta get lit. You gotta live a little bit, live a little bit, live a little.
Okay, Chaz, have you ever been to Napa?
No.
Okay, we gotta get you out here, and then I can give you a hug, and I can pour you, like, more than this of wine, and we can have you here in person, and maybe have you perform, if we're lucky.
I would love that. I love that.
It would be so much fun. Okay, so Live a Little, tell me about that one. A little bit.
This is a very different song for me because so, like, all of my songs, other than Live a Little, and I think I have a weird relationship with this song, and I don't really talk about it publicly, but I think it's fine too. Every song of mine but Live a Little has been, I started it, it was my idea, I wrote the bulk, I wrote, like, a verse and a chorus and took it to a friend and said, help me expand this, or I finished it and I produced it. Live a Little was the opposite. Live a Little was my friends Kevin Griffin and Stevie Aiello had written this chorus and sent it to me and said, hey, would you want to write more for this? And at the time, I thought, yeah, this will be a good sync song. We wanted it, because it's so much of my stuff is about, like, gray areas and in-betweens and, like, in-progress pieces, and Live a Little is very certain. It's very, like, yeah. It's a golden retriever of a song, and I felt really uncomfortable with that, because it's not, and I worried, like, oh god, is that going to come off as fake? And maybe it did, I don't know, but I do like singing it, and they, you know, we thought, what's the harm? Let's finish it together, and then it found a home in this ad campaign for this Apple TV nature documentary series narrated by Paul Rudd, which was like, yeah, cool. And then it came out and it just hit a million. And it's this song that, you know, it's so weird for as weird as I feel about it, because I'm not the one that wrote, like, the bulk of it. And I feel like my contribution was so small. It It's the one song that 5-year-olds and 80-year-olds like in my catalog. And everyone else is like, it's like these songs hit teenagers and 20-somethings and 30-somethings and 40-somethings. But Live a Little, I get videos of toddlers dancing to it, and I've got older family members that tell me that's the one of yours I really like. And you know what? I can't... Yeah, like, sure, it's a big, dumb golden retriever of a song, but is that so bad? if that's, like, the one song I've got like that? It's so bright and sunshiny, and I'm terrified of being the bright, sunshiny guy. But you know what? It's a good song, and I've seen messages from people saying, like, hey, I have cancer, I'm dying soon, this song is inspiring me to, like, go live and, you know, like, finish my bucket list and stuff like that. And, like, fuck me. You know, I can't. Like, who cares how it started?
Right.
Because that matters for people.
Okay. On three, because I'm going to use my... This isn't actually a rule, but I just assume it kind of is, like, without being spoken. On three, at the same time, we're gonna say, who F-wording cares? And you raise your water bottle. Maybe it'll turn into wine magically. I think these are the magic words, though. But on three, we're gonna say, who cares, okay?
Okay.
And everyone at home, do the same, because it's... The weekend.
Yes, yes, and we got one more song.
Ready?
Yeah.
On three. Wait, are we doing it after three or on three?
Let's do after three.
Okay, perfect. That's what I was going to do. Okay. One, two, three. Who fucking cares? Live a little.
Live a little.
All right, everybody. So, this has been Chaz Cardigan. Why can't fashion designers play Uno, Chaz?
Oh, God. Why?
Because they always draw a cardigan.
Wow. I love that, actually. I'm going to steal that.
What did the magician say when his girlfriend was taking too long shopping for sweaters?
Something about disappearing?
Pick a cardigan. Any cardigan. What do you call it? What do you call it when a cardigan's thrown away?
What?
A discardigan.
Oh, a discardigan. Wow, I like that.
Oh, boy. All right. Thank you so much. I'm excited for this last song. And to everyone who's tuned in, sorry, first of all. And thank you for tuning in to Jam Happy Hour. Check out all the links we've been posting today. And thanks, Ryan, for the 4 haws.
Discardigan.
Yes, I love it. All right, let's get it.
Sam Jam, thank you all for having me do this. This is my last one, so let's play the biggie. Oh, once I take the headphones off. Senior prom, ripping couches in the basement of a country club. That was my first panic attack. I knew I couldn't get my youth all back. I got a temper from my old man, used to black out. Then I started drinking liquor till my cash ran down. I was living in the house with the band. Couldn't pay rent, couldn't keep a job, didn't have a plan. Some days, man, I got it all together. Most days, though, I'm just trying to get better. Everybody's got that Sunday. With love and money, yeah. Woo! Even when it pulls me under, I get so high that it just seems funny, yeah. Woo! How many times can I fake it before it breaks me? I'm not okay. I'm not okay. I'm not okay. 23 and skipping obligations for some fake crush. When I start to lose my patience, I get stoned, I'm going too fast. What a rush when we finally crash. I know a little bit more now than I used to, but at the cost I paid, I'm pretty sure I got screwed. I spent a few nights sleeping in my car. Took it too far a couple times, getting kicked out of the bar. Some days, man, I got it all together. Most days, though, I'm just trying to get better. Everybody's got that someday. Money. Yeah. Woo! 50, I'll figure it out. Get my shit put together in a nice clean house. Maybe it's a pipe dream. Yeah! Everybody's got that something they can't fix with love or money.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was so fun.
So much fun. Chaz Cardigan, everybody. Oh, thank you. Hope everyone's doing slightly okay wherever you're at.
We're getting
back to live music soon. And so basically in the chat, before we head out, let us know what was your favorite song, or let us know where you've seen Chaz live, where you're tuned in from, if you want Chaz to come to wherever you're at and perform. Like, let us know. We want to just see things in the comments. We love to see it.
Yeah, I definitely, God, I can't wait to get shows again. It's such a struggle right now because everyone's trying to book at the same time.
Yeah, it's been a crazy world. So like right now that like things are slightly returning to what was just our day-to-day, you know, we took for granted type of life, it is pretty crazy. And you know, we were quarantined for so long. And speaking of, one more joke before we head out of here.
Okay.
Quarantine Star Wars troopers, they're always like, I miss people throughout COVID. And it's like, first of all, you always miss, so thank you.
Yes, I love it. I love it. Sam, thank you so much.
Thank you, Chaz. Thank you to everyone who's in the comments, like all the love that you obviously deserve and have through these comments, through Discard again, the new coin term, Discord. I think, are you on Twitch too sometimes?
I should get on Twitch. I should hop on Twitch.
But for everyone who's watching, if you're not already following Chaz on Instagram, that's where you can get yourself updated most frequently when it comes to anything in the near future in terms of shows, etc. And find the hoodies that look really comfy and the t-shirts, all that good stuff at the website that's been linked, chazcardigan.com. And see you next time. Hopefully we'll see you in person. Hopefully Chaz will get on out here to Napa soon and we'll have a fun show.
I need to find some time to come to Napa. I'm about to move to California, so I should actually come to Napa.
Yes, please. I will show you around. I grew up here, so I know all the fun stuff.
Sam, thank you for the great questions tonight. Thank you for the thoughtfulness and just all of it. It's been really fun.
Good. I'm glad. Thank you. Thank you for everything. Beautiful music, beautiful person that you are. Thank you.
Love y'all.